Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the chairman of the World Taxidermy Championships and the World Fish Carving Championships, Larry Blomquist.
This is going to be a wonderful program here. We're getting ready to give our second ever Lifetime Achievement Award away. We're going to do a giveaway. I don't want to say that. I'm a little nervous about this. The reason is, this is a close friend and somebody that is so deserving of a major award. I can't begin to explain the emotions that I feel when we do this. We're going to show a short program about Simon Blackshaw, who many of you have met, been critiqued by, been lectured by, and many of you have applauded here at this World Championship. Ken, if you would, please play the program.
Best of the World for Reproduction is a fabulous little gecko from S.T. Blackshaw from the Netherlands.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't do it. Okay, I'm just so pleased. This is the culmination of my career and everything I've dreamed of. We've been welcomed here with such hospitality at the World Show. It's just amazing, and I hope that we can possibly do something that is anything like this back to you for any of you that come to Europe. Thank you.
Here has had their moments in the shadows. I feel incredibly honoured to have played my small part in this awesome event, and I thank you all so deeply for this experience and my realisation that we are all so completely different, yet so completely and gloriously the same. I thank you.
Simon Blackshaw's story began in 1957 when he was adopted by an English couple. He attended the Warwick School, which is the oldest boys' boarding school in England. The classroom studies were strict, but his budding interest in the outdoors took hold at an early age, and he befriended the castle gamekeeper. This kindled his growing love of nature and the beauty he saw in every animal. Hunting, fishing, and shooting became a very large part of his life. Very early, Simon's natural abilities for art, from painting to taxidermy, became his central focus, but another profession would keep him busy during his early adulthood. His first career nourished his love of the outdoors, a study of arboriculture. With a vocation in forestry and woodland arena, it brought Simon more into contact with other hunting, shooting, and fishing fanatics. Simon's natural abilities to recreate wildlife in several art forms caught the attention of his friends. Everyone seemed to want a wildlife painting or portrait, or to have him mount their latest hunting trophy. It was now much more than a hobby he loved. Simon has traveled the world, and he has absorbed nature's beauty from the mountains of Europe to the deserts of Africa. He has worked with three international museums, studying and recreating much of the animal kingdom. After years of recovering from a terrible logging accident, he opened his own taxidermy studio in Heiseten, a little village in the south of Holland, in the 90s. His life has been busy ever since, with commissioned sculptures and canvas paintings, along with taxidermy for sportsmen and museums. In 2001, Simon attended his first World Taxidermy and Fish Carving Championships. Simon wrote a letter about his first experience at the World Championships, saying, "Walking into the competition area at the World Show in 2001, for the first time, was an experience never to be forgotten. Like a small child in a candy shop, all I could do was stand and stare, filled with total awe at the beauty, dynamics, and magnificence of all the entries. So much devotion to detail, so much professionalism, so much love and respect for the diversity of life. That is Simon, always respecting the work of others, when in his own right, at that time, he was one of the best taxidermists in the world. On that first trip to the World Show, he won two Best in World titles, the Judge's Choice Award for the Best of Show and the Carl E. Akeley Award for the Most Artistic Entry. He went on to do more in fish carving, winning three world titles in 2003 and 2005 and Judge's Best of Show in 2005. Simon's contributions to both taxidermy and fish carving around the world are many, but none stronger than the inspiration that he has given other budding artists. In 2009, he was commissioned by World Show organizer Larry Blomquist to do approximately 12 drawings to support a new score sheet for judging taxidermy. He completed the task not by doing 12, but by doing 54 new study drawings. Beginning with this 2011 World Taxidermy and Fish Carving Championships, the judge's Best of Show title will be named the Simon T. Blackshaw Award for the judge's Best of Show. We are proud to present the second ever Lifetime Achievement Award to one of the best, Simon T. Blackshaw.
Well, dear friends, if there ever was a reason to be disappointed in myself, this is it. That Mario and I cannot be here with you this evening is something we had never imagined possible. But Mama did say, life is like a box of chocolates, and you never know what you're going to get. So now, as I'm rapidly slipping into my own demise, thoughts of the World Show, the magnificent craftsmanship, the organisers, the competitors, and above all, the wonderful characters that have been such dear friends over the years, are a very warm embrace. It softens the reality of my situation. And my only regret in this glorious gift of life is that I didn't meet you all earlier, so that we could have spent more time together, and that we could have ventured even deeper into our mutual love of artistic natural creation. For this is the most amazing profession, and I am so happy to have devoted my life to pursuing it. But time, and above all shortness of breath, prohibit me from thanking everybody by name for their gift of friendship over the years. However, Larry and Kathy's part in the grand plan deserves serious recognition. Their contribution to my life, and that of so many others,
is as astonishing as it is magnificent. They have raised our standards. They have given us direction. And they have given us a cause. And they have given us a goal. And if all that wasn't enough, in their incredible generosity, they have decided not only to honour me with a Lifetime Achievement Award, but also to give my name to the prestigious Judges Award for Best of Show. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for the magnitude of this honour. And I cannot even begin to express how much this means to me, or even suggest how much you have all meant to my family and I, and the influence you have had in our daily lives. Because you see, this taxidermy family that we have all become influences the minds and hearts of so many people across the world with its kindness and its commitment to our cause and the way it helps colleagues and strangers alike. We share our creativity. And we share our lives. And what pride I feel to have witnessed this unique and treasured world, to have been able to share my time with some of the finest individuals that have ever walked the earth. And so, my dear friends, it rests me only to wish you all an exceptionally good life, trusting in the fact that you will continue to uphold the highest standards in our wonderful profession, and that you also make the time to smell the roses along the roadside, and make time to stop and help those that stumble along the way. And in this glorious world that we are all so honored to be a part of, unleash those creative talents and strive for absolute perfection. I thank you all deeply for being who you are and doing what you do. Live well, my friends, because life is good and beautiful memories last forever. Thank you.
Learn and the motivation to be better artists. Thank you so much, Simon.